class 6 of course, the number 4 seed in Group A. Sadly for her, she finished bottom of that group. The Olympic champion, Li Shuerei, she's already into the final, having beat Bei Yongju in the semi-final earlier today. The number 2 seed, Simon Awell, finishing third, having won her last match against Bei Yongju. It was all a very tight affair as to who was going to qualify as second from Group B, but in the end, Bei Yongju needed to do was to win one game against Simon Awell. She duly did that, and therefore qualified for the semi-finals. So here is the former champion, Wang Shixian, 23-year-old from Chuzhou in Jiangsu province, 2010 winner of the Super Series finals, which of course was played in January 2011. Super Series title earlier this year. It's obviously loves playing here in Malaysia, as indeed most of the players do. There's always a great atmosphere. It's badminton loving nation. So Wang Shixian last year was beaten in the final. Start to Li Shuerei. There was a game in 15-4 down when she retired injured, so if she were to win this match, then it would be a repeat of last year's final in the women's singles. The crowd eagerly anticipating this one, and it's got a similar situation to something we saw earlier in that the players' kit looks almost identical from behind. Of course, Wang Shixian from the front, her shirt is black, but when we look from behind, it's yellow, black shorts, and her opponent has got yellow shirts and black shorts. That's one of the BWF rules, is that players should be wearing distinctly different coloured clothing. So the number one seeds, number one on the Super Series, having played in nine Super Series finals, reached four finals, winning one of them. It's the French Super Series. Won one of her matches in the group stage in two straight games. And it was Wednesday that she played against her opponent of today, Tai Su Ying. And that was 51 minutes, as indeed was her match yesterday against the number 4 seed, Pontic and Prasatuk. The 19-year-old, winner of the Japan Open Super Series last year, and as I say, in Malaysia this year. 10 tournaments for her. Only one she missed were India and the China Masters. Super of 9. As indeed is her world ranking. Now, of course, you're wondering how she qualified then when it's only the top 8 players to qualify. I can tell you that the number 8 ranked player was Wang Yihan, the 2011 champion of the Super Series finals. Now, of course, you're only allowed 2 players per nation in the Super Series finals, and with Wang Shixian and Li Shuerei, the former champion Wang Yihan, not invited to play these finals, and therefore Tai Su Ying got her chance, and my goodness me, she's made the most of her chance so far. Lost as we've already said, against her opponent of today on Wednesday. On Thursday, beat the number 4 seed, yesterday had a marathon match, eventually coming through against Sungji Hyun, 21-15 in the deciding game. Semi-final. Now we are waiting for the umpire to make the announcements. Kerry Wong-Chi-Yun from Hong Kong and Eric Kirk from Denmark is the service judge.
Ladies and gentlemen, on my right, Tai Jing, Chinese Taipei.
Two different styles, which you can really see, it's very technical, but if you look at the way that Tai is holding on the rackets, he's holding a more thin grip way, which you see most men also doing, and we see Wang is more in a panhandle grip, where it's more faced to the net, which gives some power, but limits some technique. See, that's exactly what you can use in one grip. You can get a lot of power from that. Fantastic. She doesn't expect that.
But what I do like about the grip of this lady is that she has a very long grip.
Yeah. Well, I didn't say I didn't like the grip.
No,
I just pointed out there's a difference in the way there.
Yeah.
There's advantages and pros and cons with both grips. But she just seems to hold a really low down run, which gives her kind of loose grip,
yeah.
I also think she needs it when she holds it at that point. The Tai is holding further up on the rack.
Three, five.
she holds the racket like that, she can turn and kind of go from right to left instead of forward and just giving her that extra spin on the shuttle. They sit in a deceptive jump as well, so. It's almost in that position when she's hitting it. And of course it's something that Tai has to be aware of. And I think she has to show now that she's going to close that corner. She has to close that corner. And then maybe force Wang to play some other shots. So much power in it, she fell off the court. So, it was all or nothing.
She's always an exciting player to watch.
Yeah.
Great to watch.
Very short serve, but it's that corner again. Obviously something that Wang has been looking at when putting in the tactic against Tai. She probably learned it from the last match this week.
Yeah.
Is that deep backhand corner, or the front backhand corner is her weakness. So every time there's a chance, she's playing it to that corner. Take away from Tai, you know, it's in her genes to try and do something. And when it succeeds, it's amazing, you know. But when it doesn't, it looks a little bit like it wasn't necessary.
Yeah.
Same with the thing we talked about with Tago today, it's a little bit the same.
People where she got her Hamilton jeans from on the coaching bench. In fact, they've got off the coaching bench. Dad's got off the coaching bench. Mum stayed there.
Mum's angry.
And Dad's going to give him the coaching advice. 11-5, the advantage to the former champion.
See if he can stop that fire that Wang started with. Because he's really playing well.
I think I might have challenged that.
Yeah. Again, we have the situation again where Wang should look showing what it is. But then again, Tai could adjust the challenge. So. She's found the hit.
13-7.
These Super Series finals, the last three Super Series events, she reached the final of all three, winning the French Super Series, beating the finalist at China and then Hong Kong. Oh my goodness, twirl at the end of that backhand, full pirouette.
9-14.
Oh, that is tremendous. Great movement back in court. Got behind what was a very, very good lift. Played the cross-court smash for the winner. Oh my goodness. Does have a tendency suddenly to give these little cries.
Let's go. 15-11.
So Ying, I don't think there's any question, no, it was definitely long. I do enjoy the way she is so adventurous in her style and likes to command the rallies and play deceptive shots rather than just reacting to what her opponent is playing at her. Skills and so much deception. Who knows what she could achieve?
Okay.
Vision and the awareness to play that. That's just extraordinary. Delightful.
This time, I'm going to be surprised again. Just 3 points away from the set. That backhand side again. Time there is a chance to put it out in the short backhand side. That's where Wang is placing it.
It really is a winner. Leave yourself the full diagonal to scamper. Game point opportunities for Wang Shixian. Oh, it's gone out. Ooh, I'd challenge that.
Is that half a challenge? Was that a trick? That was the first time we've seen a trick challenge.
Surely she didn't forget that there's the availability to challenge.
I think it was more down to she missed it.
Long. This time she converts. Wang
21-15.
Third time of asking. In the opening game to the number one seed. 21-15 and 20 minutes of play. Shixian. Two previous appearances at the Super Series finals, and twice. Still playing on finals day. Could she make it three in a row? She's halfway there already. Having taken the opening game, 21-15.
A little bit more. Wang is going to be forced to play the net. And she has got to find the right length. She's in trouble. Great shot.
Service over.
Incredible skills at the net.
One hole.
Has improved a lot over the last half a year, but Tai just showing that it's a trademark. It's wide. You can see where the shuttle landed there. It's at least 1.5 meter from the back. court. That should indicate to Tai that she can use a little bit of more power on her left. She has to be more disciplined, rally a little bit more open, up with some clears and things going Tai's way.
Chen Jin, 2010 world champion, Olympic bronze medalist from Beijing, now coaching women's singles players.
Her skills at the net. The right idea. Gave Wang a long run from one corner of the court to the other. Her character though. I think if she's to improve even more, that she needs to come in to be more disciplined. because you can't give points away like that.
No. But as I said a little earlier, the fact that she has got so many skills, when she does become more consistent with those skills, who knows what she could achieve.
Oh yeah, definitely. But sometimes, no matter how good you are, it's just not there. Just feels a little bit like that today, and then she has to accept it and do what's necessary, and that's what she does then. Using the net when she's up there. She is very skilled. She has a lot of tricks in the back when she's up close to the net. She can go cross, she can play the straight one as she does there when she holds it a little bit. So might have been a good shot, but today is not working. You're Wang, you know, that's almost a double point. You know, even though you won the point, you also see that she's not willing to work for it, or she can't help trying something. That just gives Wang a lot of confidence that even that she's in trouble during the rally, she just needs to hang in there, and there might come one of these mistakes.
Shixian, I've just noticed over the last few minutes or so, it's taking longer and longer in between points.
Yeah.
And we've talked about this in the past with this particular player. Quite surprised that the umpire, a couple of points ago, allowed her to go and tell down and have a proper timeout.
And that was even after she told her to hurry up.
Yeah.
And then when she's down that road, the umpire, she needs to continue.
So we've done
it's apparently something she has
closest,
and she needs to be strict on.
8-10.
Tell you that Wang Shixian was retying a shoelace, or adjusting the shoe anyway. That's wide.
So this over 11-8 interval.
So a 3-point advantage. 11-8 mid-game interval. think that's the sort of exuberance that you want to try and curtail, because there's no need for a sort of pirouette at the end of that.
I don't know, yeah. Yeah, and she should, you know, she should see what's going on the other side. She should see that client is taking more time.
Also feeling it.
Of course, but she doesn't, and you're, my apologies, you're totally right, because we don't know why she's doing
11,
these three shot mistakes.
That
can be out of desperation, that you just simply don't feel that you have the fitness to continue the rally, so you could be right.
After a short rally, when you just had a timeout in the middle of the game.
Good rally. I was up to the umpire not to let them tell down.
Service over.
It's now 9-12.
She's missing a lot of length, Ty.
13-10.
She needs to find that back line. It's way too short.
That's the big difference. When it works, it is delightful.
It has to matter.
12-13.
Yeah, but you see, you coaches, you see, that's... I can understand why you say that. But to me, I'm watching a 19-year-old girl, and I like to see her going for this, because I think the consistency will come within 2 or 3 years. My fear is I've seen players in my home country that coaches are so worried about them making errors when they try these extravagant shots or real skill shots or difficult shots, and then they become very ordinary players and they lose that flair.
Yeah.
So
no, but that's not what I'm trying to talk I'm trying to just say there is situations in rallies where it should be used.
Yeah, I appreciate that.
When she isn't, I fire away. Yeah. Even without her dad putting fire out. Do all these things. I believe in that too. I believe that you have to be able to do these things to become a world-class badminton player. But there is times when you are outplayed a little bit and you're behind in the rallies where you shouldn't use them.
Yeah. Yeah.
That's why.
And that's why you're such an excellent coach. And you're not.
14-0.
Now, 14-0. This is a crucial phase of the match.
Yes. I think Tai has all to play for here. She has a little bit of momentum.
Wang Shixian just thinks she serves.
17-16. He's learning to try those two shoelaces a little bit better. Is it called a double nut? Six. Oh, great shot.
Yeah. Up with her little cries now.
He wanted to respond.
one long.
Service over.
Point for point.
18-all. She's missed it. Service over.
Really, really went for it there.
19-all.
Started it.
Yeah, exactly.
So get on with it.
Yeah, that's wasted a bit more time. Give them a little of a breather. So Ying. I think fans here would love to see a third and deciding game.
Do you like entertainment?
I love watching badminton like this. And I know you get frustrated when she goes for too many shots, but I just love it. Confirms the umpire. 46 minutes. And it is one game all. Look at the joy from Tai Su Ying. Why not? Lovely play. 21-19. Second game. And everything to play for. Third and decider. Player in the tournament, 20-year-old Tai Su Ying. Crowd seem to be very much behind her.
momentum. She looks much sharper.
Yeah.
She also looks much better in the physical state than Wang is. Oh, beautiful. The problem for Wang is that Tai is not falling for those cross-cut shots anymore that she fell for in the first set. So her solutions are, you know, a little bit limited. And then we come down to the grip again. How many more things can she come up with other than that cross cut from the backhand side where she's already standing there. It's difficult to to know if it's just old playing.
Generate. Not the tallest of athletes. short initially, that dive. Yeah, she's got to learn to do the Lee Chong way, bounce back up again.
It's good to see she can smile in the middle of it.
Yeah. And she does love her... You can tell she loves hitting shuttles. She loves being on a badminton court. Stretch like that, I'd never get up again.
That would have been injury for sure for me.
9-7. Hey.
Exactly 1 hour, this semi-final has been in progress. Of Tai Su Ying was when she reached the final of the Singapore Super Series event as a qualifier. 15 years old she was in 2010.
11-8.
Reached the final when she was 15. Played the final when she was 16. So 16th birthday when she played the final. Ying has lost her discipline, or that.
Yeah, but I actually did after the second set. I thought Wang looked a little bit tired, more tired than tired. But she's doing some mistakes where you can say that if you're in there on court and you feel that you are on top of it and you're physically better than the other one, you would make those mistakes. And this is a great shot. Well gone out, so unbelievable. So unless she comes up with something now, Ty, I think it's gonna be difficult. Benefit she has now when she's on the side where she has to draft against her. Use the backcourt. It is so hard to be on the side where Wang is now. Invest in it. Down there.
Service over. 10-13.
Because they have been getting on the back of Wang Shixian.
We saw what happened in the second set.
Yeah.
Yeah.
good idea.
15-12.
Just wrong execution.
Challenge than that one. But the crowd is getting into it again for fun. Every time.
Service over. 16-13.
Similar to the second set.
19-year-old after that rally. Look at the body language. 3 points away from Shixian from her third consecutive final at the Super Series finals. Except it's not consecutive, is it? 2010 she won, so it was played in 2011.
18-14,
paid. Missed out in 2011, beat the finalists last year.
Whereas now she's on her way to another thing.
Yeah.
Something that Ty has to go home and work on the fitness. I think that's mainly what she loses on today. good thing with that is that's something you can do something with.
Yeah, relatively easily.
Yeah. It was more difficult if she couldn't hit a backhand or a cut. So I can pretty much say if she got really, really up to the standard of Wang in fitness and further than her maybe, then this match could have had a different outcome.
Well, it's not over yet.
Something special, and that was special.
Six, 7 points.
Unbelievable.
Can she keep that momentum going?
What a match.
Herself. net shot. And I said at 14-19, this is not over yet.
No, it definitely wasn't.
What a match. 22-20, deciding game. An hour and 17 minutes of wonderful, wonderful badminton. Their confirmation of the score, 15-21, 21-19, 22-20, from 14-19 down and three match points down. Tai Su Ying is into the final of the Super Series finals tomorrow.
We're here with Tai Su Ying. Tai, do you want to tell us what happened there?
Can you give us a little bit of the process?
Today, actually, I played against him for the second time this match. Then, I lost in the group. Then, also, because I played against him, actually, everyone has played against him. And I lost 10 times.
10 times.
Then, 10 times. 这次可以赢，就是还蛮开心。
This is the second time she met Wang Shixian in this tournament, and she lost in the group stage. And before that, she lost four times, so she's very happy that she can win today.
I can imagine. So what did you put into your game just now to win?
你刚才胜出的秘诀是什么东西？
就是我觉得我放得很轻松， 而且我觉得观众一直在帮我加油。
Okay. She says she's very relaxed and thanks for the crowd support all the time.
Okay. Was that your parents over there? And what did they say to you when you saw them?
那你父母刚才在比赛过后有对你说什么东西吗？
他就希望我压力不要太大， 尽力去发挥， 然后拼每一颗球这样。
过后呢？比赛赢了之后呢？
每一场他都对我说一样的话。
Okay, her parents told her not to put too much of pressure, just enjoy the game.
I was about to say, the final tomorrow against Shuri, how do you think it's going to go?
决赛和李雪瑞的交手你怎么看？
好像记录也是输了四次吧。
It looks like she also lost to Li Xuerui four times.
So it means you're going to win, right? Congratulations, Tai Tsuying. Thanks so much.
Well, what a winning singles that was. Tai Tsuying coming from 14-19 down in that deciding game. Just one more semi-final to come and one place remaining in tomorrow's finals. It's mixed doubles, it's the defending champions. Doubles groups, and of course we've already witnessed earlier today,
ladies and gentlemen,
this evening the Olympic champions beating the Malaysians in two straight games. Of course, this is a Group B match we're about to watch, with the defending champions, in fact two-time winners, Nielsen and Pedersen. Very quickly, because I can see that the court officials are coming onto court, but I do want to just ask you, we've just seen the most